Thank you so much for sharing your time with me. It is Sunday. It's Let's Talk Business. And I'm JB Bryan, the President and Chief Investment Officer. That means I established and created the Afroeconomics Investment Portfolios. Yes, indeed. And JB Bryan Financial Group is my registered investment advisory firm that I created in 1995. Remember, registered investment advisory firm means that I am regulated. If you don't hear someone say that, then that means they're just telling you something. When I tell you something, it is designed to be in your best interest, and it is to be the truth, at least the truth as I see it, and hopefully the truth as regulators see it. So be very careful who you take your financial advice from. Be very careful and conscious. And so the Afroeconomics program is a strategic financial management program designed for the advancement of Black wealth, utilizing the expertise, experience, and my full commitment to making sure that you get proper knowledge, knowledge that can empower you, knowledge that you can use anywhere in any capacity, not just uniquely with just my firm. But I'm hoping that when you do make your financial decisions, you will consider me indeed. So always call 1-844-JB-Bryan or check out jbbryan.com. Check out afroeconomics.com. Come to the workshops. Today is one of many free webinars that I also post on the YouTube channel. And so our YouTube channel library is like up to like 800, you know, very close to 800 different financial topics. How in the world I did it, I do not know. But I thank you for making it possible. And I thank you once again for the Black Business Summit, the first one that was held over last weekend, a week from today. We were going hardcore grinding from 10 to 4 in Richmond, Virginia. So the next one is during Black History Month, and it's in Washington, D.C. at our Washington, D.C. office. I have a classroom in there. So definitely make sure you take advantage of the registration. And for members, it's absolutely free. And it is all about the things that we talk about today. So let's talk about being the best at what you do, being the top and the most highly recognized in your field, and staying that way, being sustainable. That is the challenge. And I can tell you that having a business that I started in 1995, same firm, same name, same owner, totally me, that it is indeed a challenge to not just be there, but stay there. Anybody can do something, but can we do it well? Can we be the best at what we do? Can we make it right? Well, let's see. So first of all, I encourage you to, in order to be the best at what you do, I say that you need to make sure that you're in a field that you love, that you have to love what you're doing, that you have to discover a unique expertise that you have, but you also, most importantly, love doing it. Because you can be very good at something, but you don't love doing it, you know? So, but when I'm talking about being the top in your field, people have to feel your love for what you do. That's what I hope that you feel from me, that you say, like, this girl loves doing this. That's why she does it. Yes, yes, and yes. Don't you ever doubt the fact that I love seeing you getting financial empowerment. Your wealth brings me extreme joy. Yes, and yes, and yes. So discover your unique expertise and do what you love. That is a first idea that I suggest for staying and being and staying on top and being the best in your chosen field. And then a second is to learn through doing. Learn through doing. Like, look, I'm from the South. So what I'm saying is doing, like D-O-I-N-G. So your actions are priceless. And that, yes, our education is cool, but there's a point where we have to close the books and we got to get into the nitty gritty and we got to do this stuff. So we got to learn through doing it. Like if you're a hairdresser, right? You do hair for a living. And you read all those books, There's a point where you got to get your technical skills up. You got to prove that you really know how to fix an afro, right? You got to do it. You can say, well, you do this, but can you really do it? Well, that's where becoming the best at your field, that's where it really pays off. Hey, that's cool. Some people get stuck and they never get to the point where they close the books and get to work. You want to be the person who learns through doing, but also learn through the books, right? You got the books, but you knew when to turn it off. You knew when to close the book and get to work. A third is, I suggest that in the first 5 to 10 years of your business, that you don't focus on just money. Like, don't focus on money. In a perfect world, don't give yourself any financial pressure at all. I remember when I started my business, the only debt I had was a small credit card debt. That's it. Car paid for, everything paid for, you know? So if you get to the point where it's like school loans were gone, and I started my business in my 20s. So you gotta, and I paid all those bills myself. You gotta get to the point where you're like, well, if I keep buying things, then I'm going to keep being in debt. So, but as a business owner, you want to be able to focus on putting money into the business. So my credit card balance was created once from the business. But before I started the business, wasn't like that, you know? And so those first 5 to 10 years, you got to be able to sacrifice, in my opinion, that everything is going into this business, preferably 10 years. Because the more you put in it, the better it's going to do. Like, you know, you got to say, the word says, bring up a child in the way that they should go so that they won't depart from it. So he gave us like, you know, now we have like 18 years of putting in on where they should go. So you put that, I'm only asking you to put a fraction of that into this business, so that it can take care of you, it can take care of itself, it can function on its own. But a lot of times people want to start a business and they think with the first 1 or 2 or 3 years, oh, that thing should be on its own by now. I should be able to take a month off by now. I should be able to go to Europe and the business operate on its own by now. You know, that's the kind of stuff you see online. They talk about, you know, the business should work itself, pay for itself. I don't care what type of business you have, even if it's all just selling products on the internet, that business has to be managed. It has to be managed, and it takes years to build a team that can operate without you being there all the time. So you got to put in. You put what you put in it, you get out of it. So I say in the first 5 to 10 years, focus on building the business, getting the experience, developing yourself, developing your team. Be productive in your 20s. Did you notice that I said I started my firm in my 20s? So a lot of times we're told, well, you know, you're just finding yourself. You'll get it together. You know, and I always thought it was an interesting interview where Steve Harvey said that he wasted his 20s and he wished that he had not, that he spent a lot of time in his 20s just partying and everything. And that even though how successful he is, he still admits that he would be doing better if he had had better use of his 20s. Or maybe it wouldn't even have taken as long, you know, to get to where he feels that he is, you know, if he had had better use. But the bottom line is he suggested, like I'm suggesting, that you have to be productive during that. I know that 10 years out of high school, I had already started my firm, you know, and I was a graduation speaker at my high school, you know, in less than 10 years of being out of school. So those are the things that you need to realize, that in your 20s, you are making a huge impact on where you're going to and how, where you're going to be 10 years from there, 20 years from now, 30 years from there, how your children are going to live, how you're going to live, how your spouse is going to live, you know, how the world is going to be. That even that young people need to realize that what you do or don't do makes a difference to the world. And we see so many young people now becoming like these multi-billionaires, you know, and the challenge for them will be the sustainable part. Because for many of them, they haven't, it was just the luck of the timing. And sometimes the timing can work to your benefit, but you have to realize, kind of like a professional athlete, that your assets and your income might get front-loaded. So your challenge will be on having to, how to make it sustainable, how to make it pay for you forever and ever and ever, how to make those successes of your 20s really work for you over the rest of your life. Say, imagine if you live to 80 or 90 and you made most of your income in your 20s. That does happen. So, but you still have the challenge of making sure it lasts, making sure it grows, going into new fields, how to make sure that your brand is sustainable, that it's still significant. You know, we still know who Dr. J is. He hasn't played in years. We still know Michael Jordan. Their brand is still strong. So just things to think about. And so I know there's like, I think it was like Miles Davis. They said that his, one of his albums is still like one of the top selling jazz albums. He's gone. He's gone. His jazz is still that appreciated. What he did is still that appreciated. You can do this. We can do this. So a fourth point is to find a mentor that is older than you, that is confident, and is at a point in their life where they want to give back. That's me for a lot of my members. I have members that are married couples in their 20s. They have they're taking advantage of Afroeconomics membership so that I can mentor them through what could have been seen as a mistake. But those are the things that are giving them power. Those experiences that I'm able to show them, like, oh, this is what I would have done. This is what I've done differently. Find a mentor. Find a mentor for you. If not, or in addition to, join Afroeconomics. Get the membership that's right for you. If it's not the family membership, it's the individual membership. But this is true. I mean, not even like just suggesting that, but this, even if I didn't have the Afroeconomics membership, I would tell you, mentoring is important. It is. As entrepreneur, the entrepreneur membership gives you access to a mentor that has had over 20 years of experience. So I'm bringing with me some of the things that, I mean, that's just unique in itself of our Black community, having another Black business that you are mentoring and building with that has to over two decades of experience to bring to you. So get a mentor, someone confident, someone committed to feeding back to the community, definitely. And then a fifth point is be creative. Now this is, I gotta do next week, hopefully if I remember it, I put in the Black Business Summit, my JB's, and now I'm not even gonna give it to y'all because you gotta come to the summit to get it. But it's JB's top 10 business tips. But this is one of them, number five for today. Be creative, not competitive. Be creative. Like, we're always trying to compete. You know that, well, we're not always trying, not us. But in general, in business, you know, there always is focus on who are your competitors. Now, it's important. That's one of the things that I have listed. It'll come up at some point. But we need to know who's doing our business. But just because they're in your business doesn't mean that they're your competitor. You know, because you have to be, you know, I do what Merrill Lynch does, you know, but they're not my competitor. You know, if someone chooses to not be with J.B. Bryan Financial Group, the home of Afroeconomics, and they want to put their assets with Merrill Lynch, you know, that's because they prefer that. God forbid. But my program is focused on something that I'm more creative from that perspective than Merrill Lynch is. They don't have a program specifically designed and researched and focused on the Black investor. They do not. They do not have a Sankofa equity portfolio. They don't. So it might be difficult for me to compete with them based on how many assets they have under management versus what assets I have under management? No, but I'm definitely more creative when it comes to serving the Black community. That's what I do, and I do it better than them. I'm on the top of my field when it comes to who I've decided to serve, who I focus on. So, that instead of saying everything has to have to be about competition, focus on being creative, and then you indeed will be the best at what you do by being more creative. You know, not just on, that they got more market share than you did, and how do I get more of that market share? Where I argue that you get all of your market share by being true to what God's purpose is for you as a business owner. Focus on doing the best for the people you were put here to serve. Who is that? That's what you have to discover. So the fifth point was be creative, not competitive. Is number six, go deeply into your craft. Go deeply into your craft. Look, I got it all upside down. Look at that. I remember that. This was my first. It's all like glossy and got my fingerprints on it. Look at that. My first Afroeconomics card. You can't tell me how excited I was. Look at that. Then I put this on the back. I was so excited. Deeply. Look, I was deep into my craft. Afroeconomics.com. Getting to the root of your money. Register today for the weekly teleconference. Look, now we all on the webinar and everything. But, go deeply into your craft and learn as much as you can about the others that are doing what you do and build on that and be more creative. Now, I expanded on that. So 5 and 6, it's about just going deeply into your field, getting an understanding of everything about the field that you are in. Everything, especially the regulation, the taxation, the future, the past, getting extreme, just getting obsessed about your particular field, all in it. If nobody is telling you that you work too much, then you probably are not where I'm talking about, because they should be telling you you work too much. That's all you think about. You should not be understood, because the most successful entrepreneurs that are the top of their game, that's all they think about, is what they have to do to bring it to you even better. So a seventh point is to change the way you see yourself. Change the way. Now, I'm talking about, I want you to be the top of your field, but you don't think that you're on the top of your field. So in order for you to get on the top of your field, you've got to change the way that you see yourself. You've got to see yourself as the best, like Money Mayweather says. reporters will ask him like over and over, like, so you think you're the best, like you think you're better than Muhammad Ali, you think you're better than everybody, Mike Tyson, you think you're better. He said, are you crazy? Do you understand that I have to see myself as the best? Now, I'm not saying that I don't appreciate them and where they were and what they did and everybody else, but you're better. If you want to be the best in your field and you want to bring it to your people, you better see yourself as the best. And by seeing yourself as the best, that means that you are willing to do what others won't. Mayweather was willing to get into the ring with a guy almost half his age and beat him down. That is willing to see yourself as the best. You got to be able to do that. But in order for him to do that, he didn't like sleep and eat steak all day. He was in there working his butt off, tearing it up, doing what he had to do, because he realized, I'm twice this boy's age almost. I got to do this thing. He wasn't smoking and drinking. He was focused on it. He knew what was needed in order to be the best. And then he said, I am going to beat you. I know I'm going to beat you because I know that I know this better than anybody else. I've been doing this since I was a teenager. So what the competitor was seeing as a disadvantage that he was old, he was positioning as a key advantage, that you don't know what I do. Like, you coming in here just for money. just for money. That's all you are, because this is some hype about money when you know you don't know this field like I do. And Mayweather was more creative, more thoughtful. He knew his field better, and he was the winner and will go down in history as the best and probably the highest paid ever because of how he learned to market himself and think through as a business person, make more money than anybody in his field for a very, very long time to come. So change the way you see yourself as the best and be the best. And then at 8th point, be healthy and have healthy habits. Vital. We can't be the best at our field if we don't have healthy habits. If I drank all last night, do you think I would be able to give you all of this today? That I would be able to share, be on top of my game, think through my things, think through the processes, not have bloodshot eyes, you know what I'm saying? Like, you cannot dog yourself out and think that you're going to be the best at your field. Not for long. I said I want you to be the best, and I want you to stay the best. I'm talking about sustainability. I'm not just saying that you were the best 1 week. You were the best. When I want them to think about JB Bryan, I want them to constantly think that this girl is on top. She thinks clearly. She has ideas. You can come at me right now with a question. I can answer it. That I can address these things. That requires a clear, drug-free, mind. That requires healthy eating, healthy habits, good exercise. That requires, because we're all going to age, but you can still be healthy at whatever age you are. There are a lot of people have my age that have a lot less healthy habits. So I'm saying that what we have to do is be healthy. The 10th principle of Afroeconomics, Black health and Black wealth. I don't care what age you are. You cannot afford to dog yourself out. We have to make healthy choices. I was watching a documentary this morning about the slave food that our community is still continuing to eat. And as Thanksgiving approaches us, it just makes us think about how we have to change it, because we're constantly bombarded with all this stuff that's supposed to be about a celebration that we weren't even at. So don't even get me there. But, my point is that as we get caught up in the season of celebration, make sure that we stay healthy, because it will kick our butt. Just at the same time, they say like some people, gain like 10, 20 pounds just over the holiday season, and do extremely unhealthy stuff to try to get it off come January, so we just have to have some really healthy habits and stop focusing so much on the external and really focus more on our substance and our internal and what we put in us and what we put in our mind, Because when our mind is healthy, everything else, we make healthier choices. We gotta know it. We know it. It's true. So be healthy and have healthy habits. Number 9, establish a plan on how you will continue to build yourself and your business continuously. A business plan is very important. Everybody that came to the Black Business Summit got a template for a business plan. So make sure you make plans. For if you don't already have your business plan set up, get the entrepreneurship membership, get the planning to go to the summit in February, do something, but make sure that you are establishing a plan to build yourself and your business and make it sustainable, and we'll get it together and we'll be accountable to each other consistently. We gotta do that. And my final point is, look, I'm at 329. It's to establish a succession plan, a legacy plan, not just a will. You need to have your will, but you need to have a succession plan on your business, how it will continue after you, who it will go on, how it will be continued. Your succession plan might be that you're going to sell it, but at some point. Well, how are you going to sell it? How do you want it to be valued? Do you want it to pay you income, or do you want to receive a lump sum of income? But have a plan, a succession plan. That's going to keep you. Now, if you want to stay and be the best on your field, then you need to know that every bit of your effort can go on to the next generation if you have a good succession legacy plan for your business. Because everything that you're putting out right now might not just benefit you. It doesn't have to just benefit you. I can help you make sure that it benefits your children, your grandchildren, your grandchildren's children, your grandchildren's children's children, and on and on and on. That's how wealthy people have to think. We have to think in generations. Unfortunately, broke people just try to make it through this day. But more and more, Afroeconomics is going to push you to continue to think in generation, in decades, and more. That's the sign of wealth. You know, you can get to the point where you can't even, you know, you can't even spend everything you got in your lifetime. And I have clients like that. They're not even worried about spending that anymore. They're thinking about, how do I make sure that the next generation does right by this? That's where you want to be. That's where you want to be. Because I'm going to tell you, the older you get, the more you begin to focus on your footprint that you leave on this planet. You know, like, what do I want to make sure is left behind? What do I want to make sure is done differently than I did it? You know, how do you want to make their life better for everybody else? That's what will happen. I promise you, if you continue to maximize this day and maximize your mindset and maximize your health and maximize your planning and maximize every moment of your life, no matter what point of your life where you're at, scratch the retirement mindset. Let's focus on that building mindset. What am I going to do every moment of my life? This particular moment that I have, I'm going to be the best at what I do, and I'm going to stay that way. We can do it. You all have a great, 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 great day. I appreciate it. The energy I felt from you all, I appreciate you. I know I do. Email me anytime at jb@afroeconomics.com or jb@jbryan.com, or go into the website and sign up for my weekly updates. Thank you, Mr. Key. Thank you. You are extremely welcome. It is a blessing for me to serve you. You all have a blessed day.